Mr. Jones. I usually look in the parking spot and I say, that's Gene, I don't care what car it is.
If I may, Mr. Chair, when I came in the building, I said, who has the car buried in snow that looks like it's been there 3 days? That's Gene's car, I was told, and then I understood why. He's probably been here for 3 days.
Right. County Finance, Mr. Thank you, Gene.
Thank you, Gene.
Flip the tab over to 12.
12.
Right next to Gene.
Next one.
And I just want to echo all the kind words that were said about Gene. Gene, I'm just amazed at what he has to do and what we ask him to do. And I try not to ask him when I can, but knowing how busy he is, and if we can fund that position, I think it'd be
smart
to be good for the town.
Good investment.
Good investment, thank you. Our budget, we level funded everything other than contractual obligations for union salaries. We wanted to set a good example for the rest of the department head, so we level funded our budget. Nothing has gone up, you'll see, other than the salary obligations. And we even cut $200 out of repairs and maintenance because we had nothing to repair. So, I'd rather see it go to Gene's budget.
What's the 37.8 under additional request?
That's in the assessing department.
Okay.
We already heard about that.
Yeah. We haven't gotten that down.
No, we already heard about that earlier.
Yes.
The yellow. You just go to the...
Yeah, okay.
The red recaps all three of the finance the budgets.
Yeah, okay. Right.
And everything...
I shouldn't be looking at this sheet.
Everything is level funded other than the contractual obligation and salaries.
The Munis system, bringing it up, is going to require an extra effort, and it's going to also result in maintaining the existing system, I would think, for a little period of time.
There'll be some overlap, yes.
Especially for the closing side. I worry about the issue of closing the end of the year, getting to a point where we get our numbers into DLR and we get our free cash certified. We thought about the issues associated with that, turning this new system on in that same critical time frame.
Well, we had a meeting with the software company last Wednesday, I believe it was, Wednesday, yes. And we decided that the best date now to go live would be January 1, 2009. It won't be on July 1st. It'll be too rushed. We could probably get the general ledger live by July 1, but payroll would be too rushed. We want to go on simultaneously so that not making at least 150 manual entries into the ledger because the payroll isn't on that. So we decided with Munis that a more realistic date would be 1/1/09.
How does that impact our overall fiscal year accounting when you have data on two systems?
We're gonna bring over
all the accounts
theirs in December.
And I'll stay in the payroll piece of it.
Now, why wouldn't we be better served, I'm just asking, why wouldn't we be better served by converting everything in July? Because I see the problem about the payroll issue, right? When you do January 1, you've got the other issue where you've got to go two systems in a year, right? Why wouldn't we be better served converting in July, right, and running a separate system, payroll, and then converting payroll in January? So if you do summary numbers in the system, and run a separate system, and then you run the old system, the payroll itself, why wouldn't that be a better, why wouldn't that be a better answer? You know what I'm saying, Joe?
Just because of the manual work. Just the manual work. It would be
Because of the extra work of
150 manual entries.
No, but I'm saying you wouldn't make any entries because you'd start payroll January 1.
Right, but your ledger, now you're the accounts that the money's coming from.
Yeah, still.
Will be in the general ledger.
Wouldn't you be able to deal that with that as a summary item? No?
No. We've talked to the schools and, in my department, it'll be 150, with the school payroll.
If you put all the information in, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying about the idea of using some information in the system, but detailed information in a separate system? Payroll's easy to do. Payroll's really easy to do, but I can see, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. I mean, you've got to make all the manual entries, all the entries to cover the first half of the year because it's a calendar year issue. I mean, you're going to have the same problem, you're not the same problem, but you're going to have a similar problem if you go to January 1 and do it in the fiscal year, right? It seems to me, aren't you?
No, not really. We just bring
what
over the totals.
What are the adjustments you got to make when you
do just bring
January
over
1?
The totals.
Just bring over the totals?
Bring over the totals, what we spend for this, for example.
The system won't reflect the whole year, though. It'll only reflect the half year.
No, but you'll have the totals in there.
Not the transactions.
Not the transactions. You'll have
summary.
Yeah, but I like the idea of a full year of the transactions. I mean, I don't know. I mean, if it's going to work, I can see it. But to start in January, half year.
But it's done
just
all the
for
time.
Payroll.
You can do it on a quarter year. You can do it. You know, we talked about October, but
we'll look at
that. That's unrealistic.
We'll leave to the experts, I guess. The concern I have is whenever I've been involved with a cutover, everybody, in all cases, the amount of resources required to make the cutover is underestimated. Result, there are issues and things that just become extremely stressful and create numerous problems and mistakes. And I just want to make sure that cycle here in the process of making this change, whether it's July 1st or it's January 1st or it's in the next fiscal year, that we in fact have looked at that and planned accordingly and make sure that we have the appropriate resources in place so that we make this thing successful. That's very important.
Well, we figured January 1st cutover would give us ample time, without rushing things, getting everybody trained.
January 1st, we're also in the beginning of the budget cycle.
You could say there's never a good time.
Right, there's never a good time.
My concern is more, have we thought it through to the point where if we need additional services, professional services, or additional overtime during this transition period to make it successful, that we include it in the budget?
I don't see where we need any overtime.
I don't know. What I'm saying is that every time I've been involved with one of these things, it's been painful.
You've underestimated yourself.
And it's because it ends up being a lot more work.
Well, the way...
That transition, that's all. And
well, with the software company, we plan on being done December 1st. And then we just run a parallel system for a month, and then we should just, we should cut right over on January 1st without any problems. You know, that last month, we're really targeting December 1st to have everything done, everybody trained, everything in, you know, everything installed, everything in place. And then, and that's before we really get into the budget and the tax rate. By then, yes.
That service you tested for it, what would you do?
Well, if we're ready in November, we will.
I mean, is there a plan to go one to one or is it?
Yeah, we'll probably have all the testing done by December.
And a full testing version, where you simulated going live?
Yes. That was her comments on Wednesday. That's how we left it. So we should have a couple of, we'll have a couple of 3 months of running it parallel.
Yeah, you're gonna need some more time and reasons to don't sell short.
I know, but we're trying to, you know.
Well, it's gotta be successful, okay?
That's the key.
The town's gone through, they purchased software back a number of years ago. And it was wasted money.
Yeah, I'm well aware of that.
We also have a situation where we can't go too many more years in the future with the existing system.
No, I know that quite well. Yes. That's why I want to move forward. I don't want to let it sit and, you know, we'll do it next July, we'll do it next
year.
Well,
I want to move forward, too. I wanted to have it online on July 1st, but I'm also can be a realist and say if that's impossible, then it would be foolhardy to try it because it would fail.
Well, that's why we moved from the July 1 day.
Okay. Well,
January 1st gives us enough time to complete everything.
And I'm going to ask the question again.
You think that January 1st works best because you need that extra time.
Yeah.
I mean, Phil, the only crisis we see is what we had this year, which was with the real estate bills. We were stuffing real estate bills on the 29th of December, and it was all hands on deck to do that. I mean, it took, as you know, it took a considerable effort. Hopefully we don't repeat that because that occurs only due to the fact that the town had to get its revaluation approved from the DOR.
But that is
something that does concern me.
Well, I mean, I can buy the January 1st date if it's the time. I mean, but absent that, I'd rather start July. I mean, we don't need the time. We need the time. Hey,
it wouldn't be July.
Right. Bob's comments are right. You know, whatever we do, we've got to do right.
This July?
No.
He's saying put it off another
18 months.
No, I'm not saying put it off. I'm saying start it on July.
You're talking about
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. I'd rather start right away. But I mean, and I think payroll's not the right issue. That's me personally.
Payroll.
I see it, Joe.
Now, is this input you've got from the consultant?
Yes, project manager. We have decided to reallocate some of the funds. And we have a very short contract with the project manager just to jumpstart this again. Because we, you know, we lost touch with it, getting involved with the tax bills and the tax rate. We met Thursday with our chart of accounts person, and so that seems to be more moving forward. And we had a call, just to add a comment about, gee, we had to call him away what he was doing to set up projector for us in room five, in order to for this person to make his presentation. Just a little side note. But we're back on track. We want to move forward, and January 1 seems realistic.
This project manager is going to be followed through all the way through the whole version and everything.
No, he understands. He's just he helped us. Like I said, jumpstart the project again. If I get additional funding, he'll stay with us through the whole thing.
That's up with Bob on this one. Yeah, I think that's money well spent.
It is, because he knows things.
I mean, that's what we need, is some plug in the works.
But that's exactly what he is.
Well, when we met a few weeks ago, we talked about getting a more detailed timeline. So if there's an adjustment to the timeline, we still need project manager is the right person to, because of the expertise.
See, now that the server is being installed, which happened today, and like Gene said, it'll finish tomorrow, then we install the software, then they come in and sit down with us, then they'll give us specific dates, okay? This is what we're gonna do.
Okay, fine.
So we're almost there.
I think we need that, and we need to, you know, I need to feel comfortable. I think the rest of the board does, associated with this. I mean, you know, if it doesn't work, right, it comes back on us. We went to town meeting, asked for the money, right, and even though we're not the implementers, we're the elected officials that have convinced the public to spend this money.
What would be an estimate of keeping this project manager on board through the conversion and making sure that that's the person really riding hard on everybody? And you've got your day-to-day operations to be concerned with in addition to the stage you're undertaking. You do it all the time. That's what you're doing. You hire somebody on that committee.
He has a proposal, a low end of $30,000 and a high end of about $40,000.
And you have allocated how much already? Was that the lump deal which you already have?
No, this $5,000. Just to get us jump started. I told him my plans. I said, you know, could you jump start us? He said he would. It is. It's the same consultant that the town of Reading is using.
Are they done yet? How did it go?
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess
you're going to ask Joe then.
Yeah, oh, I don't know. I don't know.
Well, you're going to find out.
I can because I know.
Well, I think it's
well, I know when we met with the school business manager, Greg and myself, we were going to come back to you with this additional proposal, which we're more able, now we're
right,
more ready to
complete. There's at least one module.
Yeah. We need the requisitions module, but we want to drop off the crystal recording for now. It's not something we need in phase one, so it's not an even swap, but it does save us some money.
Well, we'll be back in April.
In April.
Yeah. Let's see. You should get what you need. That's the bottom line. I mean, this is important.
And this is probably one of the most important things we're going to do in the finance area.
Oh, I agree.
We put the systems in place. Now we need to get the operating software in. Once we get this completed. And you know what? It's not just town hall. It's the school.
Right, because the school will be on this new system as well.
Any other questions?
No.
So we've got to come back and revisit this issue in terms of what we need to...
Anybody, if you level funded, we're saying you got to get more.
It's good thing you didn't ask for any more money.
Well, I guess. My everyday budget, we're fine.
Anything else, Joe?
Right.
No.
Finance committee, any... other questions for Finance Director? Okay, last budget. Okay. Greg, not putting youth services.
So to have them in our 15-minute presentation is not appropriate. I think it's important for them to give you not only a budget presentation, but an update of their activities. And I'll coordinate with you with the
Administration.
Number 10? Tab 10? Tab 10 is the... Town Administrator budget, and it includes several personnel, which are in addition to the Town Administrator. It provides for the full-time Administrative Assistant, who is Linda Hamill, and a 25-hour-a-week Human Resources Director, who is Allison Wilson. And white sheet, you see the detail of the salaries that are associated with those positions. That comprises the totality of the town administrative department. Like all departments, we do a lot of different things. And I know the selectmen and the finance committee are probably aware of what they are, but they really fall into a couple major areas. And that would be management of human resources and management of finances and personnel. Specifically under the human resources, we have the obligation, legal obligation, to negotiate all of the town's labor contracts. There are 7 contracts. Also responsibility to resolve any labor disputes that result from those contracts. And all of those items are date and time sensitive. There are dates and times written into the agreements that when a dispute is filed, it needs to be adjudicated, resolved one way or the other within as little as 5 days. So unfortunately, due to the nature of the beast, there are times when you would only need to drop everything because an issue is brought to your attention. In addition to the labor agreements, the town administrator is responsible for 19 performance evaluations over the course of the year. A lot of effort and a lot of time goes into performance evaluations. Been told early in my career that if you don't spend the time and effort, then it's not even something worth something you should do. So we do a total of 19 performance evaluations. Those are all of our department heads, 16 total, and also 3 other personnel that report either directly or indirectly through the town administrator. The department is also responsible for enforcement of uniform work regulations and enforcement regulations. And really, we make sure that our department heads, in addition to doing all the work that they've told you about, also are good citizens and good employees. The second aspect of the job relates to financial management. It involves the assembling of the annual budget, which we have before you this evening, the capital budget, the revenue forecasting, including the 3-year plan that we went through back in February through April of last year. And that work is done in concert with the finance director. The final major portion of the job involves purchasing or procurement. We have a centralized purchasing system. I didn't mention about personnel, but we also have a centralized personnel system. And the town administrator is the head of that system. We have a centralized purchasing system, and the town administrator is also head of the centralized purchasing system. And that's the issuance of any bid documents, contracts, award of bids, execution of contracts, and approval of purchase orders. So all of those items ultimately flow through my office, and any disputes that result from those ultimately get resolved through the town administrator's office. Lastly, and by no means least, is I'm also responsible, as you know, for working with the Board of Selectmen, implementing your initiatives, following up on your actions, meeting with other boards and committees, including the Finance Committee and other boards, resolving the issues, responding to their requests, and being available to the public on any number of requests that cross my desk over the course of the day. So you can see that it is pretty unique. It's a, you know, it's a multi-million dollar organization. We try to run it as a multi-million dollar organization, but the chief administrative officer is available and accessible to anyone that shows up at his or her door over the course of the day. And I think you'll find that is very unique. Any private sector comparisons do not apply, because it is a unique aspect of the job that the public has a right to come in and see the town administrator at any time on any issue. And I can assure you that we do take advantage of that opportunity. It's one of the more enjoyable aspects of the job. So I apologize for the lengthy introduction. Lateness of the hour, I'm going to defer any of the additional discussion that I have prepared as a presentation, and really try to focus on the changes in the budget for the year going forward. And I think Gene had mentioned earlier about managing risk, and one of the items that this budget attempts to do is manage risk associated with the human resources function. Presently, the position is budgeted at 25 hours a week. Last year, I had proposed that the position be increased from 25 hours to full-time. This budget does that also. We didn't fund it last year, but we still do have a key risk area, and that specifically relates to labor, it relates to compliance with state and federal law, and making sure that we file documents on a timely basis. And that someone is available to review documentation that comes to me thoroughly in detail before I have an opportunity to sign off on it. That piece is really missing right now, and it requires me to do all of that individual legwork prior to something being approved, and it is quite time consuming. Presently, human resources involved in several different areas. They're responsible for the town's health insurance program and employee benefits, which is life insurance, and other dental plan that the town does offer. The enrollment of new employees, making sure that the new employees have all the proper documentation that is required through a state and federal law. The human resources department also processes all of our payroll changes and posts and screens new applicants for positions. What I would envision with the new position, or the additional component to this position, is to become more involved in the labor side. That's the area that's really lacking right now, is a review of labor contracts, review of comparable data from other communities, surveying other communities, finding out what other communities are doing differently that may benefit and be adaptable to the town and North Reading. I think that that's a critical piece that's missing right now that we want to try to get a hold of and do the best we possibly can. So that is the main focus of my budget proposal. You will find that the other areas of the budget are fairly stagnant. However, those of you who do read the detail will see that we had a big number in fiscal year 2007 for professional services. And the reason why that number is so big is that what we did was we were able to reserve monies in the fiscal year 2007 budget to the tune of $18,000 to pay for the assessment center that we will be undertaking shortly for the police and fire chief. So rather than having those dollars impact this year's budget, we were able to reserve money and essentially start that process before the end of fiscal year 2007, which allowed us to encumber some monies. So that's the reason why the number is big and looks big. It's not a number that's going to reoccur going forward in this period.
Does HR and the administration of employee benefits, specifically the health insurance, those things, is there involvement with the school employees too?
Yes, on the enrollment of some of the schools do enroll their employees in the health insurance program. However, ensuring that that enrollment information is complete and gets submitted as complete is HR's responsibility. So the intake is done through the school department. They fill out the proper forms. Those then ultimately get submitted through HR. HR does review them before they get sent out.
Yes, John.
Thank you. Greg, would we be taking our present HR person making that full-time?
That would be my goal. I do think that there's benefit to keeping the individual who's there right now. And if it means that we need to do some type of job share, one person would be eligible, obviously, and the benefits the other one wouldn't, I would entertain that also.
That was going to be my next question.
Yeah,
I
think I would look at that as an option, that's something that we would consider. That's the way that employers are able to find personnel now, is to try to be creative and find ways to adapt. Anything else on